Raiden, what's wrong? Raiden! Raiden!
Colonel, they've apparently completed the final check procedure for Arsenal gear.
Find Emma on the double. You've got to get her to install the virus program that the President gave you. When you find her, take her to the computer room on level B2 in the core of Shell 1.
Snake, did you catch all that? I didn't make it on time. Arsenal's going active.
Yeah, I heard. The hostage rescue's gonna have to wait.
I'm going after Emma.
We'll secure the computer room. Looks like we can't install the virus program without Emma.
Can't your partner do it?
I would if I could, but the security for this system is no joke. I need more time.
That's why we need her.
Understood. I'll make sure you have your family reunion. What's up?
A lot of years have passed between EE and me.
Then you should see her, right?
I don't have the right to see her.
We can talk about this later. Raiden, I think you'd better get moving. Emma's in the locker room to the north, right?
I'm on it.
May I have more rations, please? So, one reason that might not have been clear for me shooting out these lights was it actually happened once during my first attempt. Vamp can throw a knife into your shadow, and if the knife hits your shadow, you can't move. I believe it's a callback to Vulcan Raven's weird hallucinogenic tattoo of the bird that touches Snake and causes him to freeze. Also, this fight can play a lot like Revolver Ocelot in Raven's fight. Like, I was using claymores that first attempt, waiting for Vamp to hit them instead of actively fighting him. So you can booby trap. The fact you're running around in a circle definitely feels like an homage to Ocelot. And I feel like it's definitely fitting that you have the conversation with the Colonel saying, "Stop thinking so much into these things. It's nothing." Right before the first fight that feels the most like a Metal Gear Solid fight. I didn't realize I was going to go the path. I wanted to get any items. That was a mistake. I didn't mean to be so good at the video game, guys. Yeah, I want that body armor, bro. PSG1 Tranks. Let's see what else they have to say.
You can find the locker room where Emma is to the northwest of the flooded area. Go!
Go!
Raiden, we don't have much time left. Emma should be to the north of filter chamber number 2, where you fought with Vamp.
Raiden, you have to hurry. EE's life is in your hands.
Vamp mentioned a purified hydrogen bomb. Any idea what it is?
A purified hydrogen bomb is a nuclear weapon that doesn't use a nuclear explosion to trigger a nuclear fusion reaction. There are 2 theories for triggering a purified hydrogen bomb. Of the 2, our nation focused its research efforts on the laser inertial compression theory. Theoretically, it's the same as laser nuclear fusion. By solidifying deuterium and tritium at an extremely low temperature to create fuel pellets and bombarding these pellets with a high-output laser, the surface of the pellets evaporate. This creates a reaction that results in the inward compression of the pellets. The center portion of a pellet reaches the necessary extreme temperature and pressure conditions for confining nuclear fusion, and thereby creating a fusion reaction. I understand that research in this area continued into the last century, but I'd heard they hit a wall when they couldn't come up with a miniature laser capable of the necessary ultra-high output. From what you tell me, I guess I'll have to assume they overcame that problem.
Precious tritium. Only 25 pounds of it in the whole Earth. To all you youngins who don't know what I'm quoting, you'll see Doc Ock once again, Alfred Molina, in Spider-Man 3.
Think about what the ideal spot to aim for is, depending on time and circumstances. Go for the central nervous system if you absolutely have to take...
All right. We are still at tutorial messages. Okay, so there's a whole bunch of nothing. Cool. Wait, is that seriously it? Oh wow, that's seriously it. No, fuck! Well, good thing I picked up that ration. Yeah, I know.
Snake, I don't see Emma. EE!
I can't believe Emma managed to get out of that room by herself. Take a more thorough look around. The coolant spray can be a weapon. After you take someone out, after you hold.
Colonel, I'm in the locker room, but there's no one here.
Could she have gone somewhere else?
I don't think so. Emma is somewhere in that room. Search more carefully. Raiden, if you walk around with your feet wet, there will naturally be traps.
Are you all right?
Who are you?
Raiden, I'm getting you out of here.
Get me out? You're lying. Where are you taking me this time?
What are you talking about? I'm here to help. Here, I'll prove it. Do you have nanos?
What?
Well, do you?
I do. Everybody on this project has them.
Okay, good. Let's try. Can you hear me now?
Nano communication?
That's right. I have nano machines too.
Then you're not one of them.
That's what I've been trying to tell you.
And you came to rescue me?
Actually, I need your help to stop Arsenal. I understand you're the only one who might be able to do it.
And who told you that?
The president.
Really?
I need you to come with me to Shell One. Your brother's waiting for you there.
My brother?
Come on, we have to get moving. This place will be flooded soon. You can swim. You used to love it.
How do you know?
Your brother told me.
He's really here?
That's right. He's here to rescue you.
I don't believe you. He would never come for me.
And I'm telling you he's here, waiting for us at Shell One.
No! He left me, my mother, when we needed him the most. When my father died, all he could think about was himself.
Emma, we can go over all that later, but first we have to get out of here.
No! I hate water! It's hopeless! I can't swim! I can't swim!
You can do it!
I can't!
Come on, deep down inside, you know you can swim!
I can't keep my eyes open in the water. Endless blue. The water, it wants me. It won't let me go.
All right, then close your eyes. I'll guide you.
I was injected with something. My legs. I have trouble moving them.
Listen, Emma, just hold your breath. I'll do the rest. First, we'll head to filter chamber 2. Then we'll take a break.
And all I have to do is hold my breath?
That's right.
How long?
Just a little while.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. That's how I got here.
I don't think I can do it. I'm not good at holding my breath.
Look, Emma, I have an idea. Put your ear against my chest and listen to my heartbeat.
Your heartbeat?
Count the beats. Don't think about anything else. When you reach 100, open your eyes. By that time, we'll be on the other side. Give me a signal if you think you're running out of breath.
What will you do then?
I'll swim faster. Hang on tight. Okay, let's go.
I'm closing my eyes.
Take some deep breaths. One, two, three.
Wait!
What is it?
Let me take off my glasses.
You know, you should wear contacts.
There's nothing wrong with my eyes.
Hmm?
I wear them for show.
Trying to be different from the other girls?
No, it's not like that. I like glasses. And there's this guy I liked who used to wear them.
Your first boyfriend?
No. Somebody more important. Anyway, they bring me luck.
I see. Okay, let's go.
Raiden with the weird pulls. He's kind of, I think Raiden might be a piece of shit, you guys. Like, you know, you should really wear contacts. I have a feeling that was a remark that he doesn't find her attractive with glasses. also that reference to the first time he ever raised his hand to Rose. That still makes me uncomfortable. Let's see if she has anything to say.
Emma, you okay?
Yeah, sort of. Are we there yet?
It's so weird to think. So, I feel like they changed how the codec works. In the first game, it's very clear. The codec is just a radio. It's a like Metal Gear and Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake. It was just called the transceiver. It was the contribution, I believe, of Jeremy Blaustein, who is the localizer for Metal Gear Solid, to change it from the radio transceiver to the codec because he thought it sounded more technical and just cooler all around. But it was still treated very much like a radio. In this game, they changed it. It's still called the codec, but it's nanomachine communication, which is what gives them the ability to converse within like a split second. Time almost freezes, but it's not that time is freezing and that they're having a conversation. It's like these thoughts are instantly transmitting from one person's mind to the others, which is super weird to me still. I'm not sure if that's how it's intended, because it seems to change time to time. Like during the Ames conversation, where Ocelot's watching in, and they go to nano communication, they go to the codec. And then Ocelot gets frustrated because the security monitor he's watching is just dead silent. Also allows them to speak while unable to breathe when they're underwater and swimming.
I'm scared.
Even Snake in the beginning of this game, during the tanker mission, when he's talking to Otacon, it's shown that they're treating it much more like a radio, and even the codec screen's different. Like, you can see on the screen, it's very jagged. It's like the blocks underneath PTT are jagged, whereas when Snake and Otacon were talking, it was a smooth line. So maybe that's the visual indicator that this codec is different than Snake and Otacon's codec. Who knows?
I don't want to do this. I'm scared.
Raiden, take Emma to the computer room on B2 of Shell 1's core. She can launch the virus that you received from the president. It's the only way to stop Arsenal Gear. The flooding is getting worse. Go back to filter chamber number 2 where Vamp was, before the area is completely underwater. Move! When you're underwater with Emma, her O2 gauge will be displayed below your own gauge. Be careful. Her O2 gauge has lower reserve than yours.
I guess we won't have any time to waste then.
Keep an eye on Emma's O2 gauge. Take the shortest possible way to get through the flooded area. A word of warning. Weapons become useless when you're in water, though I doubt you'll be encountering any enemies underwater. When you start to feel the lack of air, hit the action button repeatedly. This will let you ration your air supply better and slow the decline of your O2 gauge. Right. That skull suit of yours is designed to minimize drag when you're underwater. Try feeling the suit's skin.
Sort of sandpapery.
What you're feeling is a series of microscopic grooves. This water-repelling scale structure cancels out the force of the currents. The suit cuts drag by a full 10%. You'll be swimming like a fish. The technology is extrapolated from the structure of shark skin. The concavity of the skin surface is designed to cut down on air drag on dry land as well. Same idea as the surface of golf balls, but improved upon.
Sounds good. I think I'm ready for the Olympics.
Oh! Wait, are those suits no longer allowed in the Olympics? I remember that was a weird thing a few years ago. So many records were broken that they were like, okay, the suits give too much of an advantage, get rid of them. But why get rid of them if everyone has access to the same tech? I feel like that's a superfluous point. No one cares about that anymore. Just me.
Intrusion view does not guarantee your safety.
Raiden, take Emma and go to Strut L. There's a ladder down onto the oil fence on the ocean surface from that strut. Punching is a basic move in hand-to-hand.
Oops, that was the wrong button.
Raiden. How are you, Emma?
Okay, I think.
How are you, Emma?
Okay.
You did good.
I concentrated on your heartbeat. It reminded me of when I was a kid. I remember my brother giving me a piggyback ride. I was sleeping with my ear against his back. I could hear his heartbeat.
Sounds like you were close.
We were, back then. We were stepchildren in our parents' second marriages. Wherever my brother went, I used to tag along. My brother didn't have any close friends, so he used to take care of me. We both wanted to be loved so much. So much that we used to pretend.
Pretend?
Yeah, we used to play house. My brother was the husband, and I was the wife. But it was always just make-believe. We were only kids. You know what I mean.
I never had a family, but I think I know what you mean.
Raiden, what's your status?
Colonel? I've got Emma Emmerich here. We've managed to avoid drowning.
Good job. Get her over to Shell 1 as soon as you can.
That's going to be hard with the connecting bridge on the upper level destroyed.
Didn't Olga say something about taking the oil fence at the bottom of Strut L?
Yeah, I remember that.
You should be able to go down by way of Strut L. Try and get over there.
What about Emma? She's been injected with something and she can't walk without any help.
Take her with you. Free your hands of any equipment and hold down the action button to give her a hand. To release your grip on her, take your finger off the action button. Emma can sit and wait until you help her back up. And be careful. You won't be able to use any weapons while you're leading her. Now head for Strut L.
We're on our way.
Raiden, we've infiltrated the computer room. What's your situation?
Emma's safe. We're heading your way.
Good job.
Shell 1's deserted. Looks like everybody's aboard Arsenal.
I had a look at the system, but there's nothing I can do. EE's our only hope.
Right. I'll put her on then.
Huh? EE? What? How?
I'll use my codec as a relay. Here she is.
Hal?
EE, is that you?
Hal.
EE. Why are you involved with Metal Gear?
Huh?
You knew our family's dark history and still got involved? What's wrong with you?
I should have known.
Answer me. Why are you repeating the same mistake?
I wanted to hurt you. I wanted to see you suffer.
E.E.?
You abandoned me.
No, that's not what happened.
All right, that's enough.
Who are you?
I'm a friend of Otacon's, Emma.
Otacon?
Enough with the sibling rivalry.
That's not what this is.
We haven't got time for this. Raiden, get her over here right now.
I...
Gotcha, Snake. I'll head over there with Emma.
Most of the enemies aboard Arsenal, but I suggest you be careful. Make sure Emma gets here in one piece.
Raiden, take care of my sister.
Don't worry. I'll get her there.
Can I throw Emma in the water?
Oh.
Oh, shit. Was that mine? Those are not mine. They put claymores in here after you leave? Scare the shit out of me, yo.
Snake and Hal are waiting for us in Shell One's computer room. I've got this disk that the president gave me. This disk is supposed to contain a virus that can corrupt Arsenal Gear's operating system. We need you to...
This is my program.
What?
Why did the president give it to you?
Huh?
Did something happen to the president?
Dead.
What?
You actually wrote this virus?
It's not really a virus. It's more like a worm cluster. It's actually a delayed effect autonomous program that's designed to invade GW's cerebrum and render its nerve connections useless.
You know what GW is?
Of course. I created it.
Huh?
You look surprised.
Well...
Cat got your tongue?
I'm sorry. How about the Patriots? Ever heard of them?
Yes, but I only know what I've been told.
Can you tell me what you know?
Sure, but it's hard to put into words.
Right. Are you reading me, Emma?
Yes, loud and clear.
The president said that Arsenal Gear was the Patriots' key to supremacy.
That's as good a description as any.
What exactly is it?
It's a massive data processing system capable of controlling information on a global scale.
A data processing system?
That's right. The system's a social device for maintaining the Patriots' control.
You've lost me.
Well, in this day and age, information emerges from every direction and is freely distributed. A variety of information gathered by servers employing the latest in high-speed communication networks and P2P technology is rapidly circulated to individuals. In fact, the speed of this circulation process is accelerating on an almost daily basis. The Patriots seem to be afraid of this development. Apparently, they believe that their role will shift from dominant to dominated.
Huh?
Let me give you an example. You're aware of Solid Snake's anti-Metal Gear activities, aren't you?
Yeah, I know a little about it.
Well, that's just a small sample of uncontrolled information. I can guarantee you the Patriots did not want Solid Snake's name publicized. Now, look at it like this. Political scandal, corporate corruption, up until now, the Patriots have managed to keep a lid on these and other self-serving events. But with their existing data processing system, they're no longer able to effectively control the flow of information generated at the individual level. With the newly created system, they can fully regulate digital information. High-level information can be categorized in stages, given clearance levels, and deleted as necessary, never to be seen by the public. By deleting such information, the Patriots can shape the course of history as they see fit.
Somebody's bound to catch on.
No, the memory capacity, not to mention the lifespan of the average individual, is extremely limited. On the other hand, digital information lasts virtually forever. It doesn't deteriorate.
So?
The alphabet. 26 letters, right? It could have been 30 letters. What if the 4 deleted letters were controlled by a program?
Impossible.
It's not. In fact, something similar is already underway. Do you know how many genes exist in an individual?
About 30 to 40,000?
Right. That's what was announced at the turn of the century. But there's actually 100,000 according to the original theory advanced by the scientific community. Information regarding the remaining 60,000 was suppressed by the Patriots.
No.
Why? How would you know? Do you know what a gene looks like? Did you count them yourself?
There are research organizations.
Of course. And their reports have already been subtly altered. They're even beginning to believe the doctored reports. GW is a system that allows the Patriots to decide what will be recorded in tomorrow's history.
So what we're talking about is one huge censorship system for deleting information which might be inconvenient to the Patriots.
Exactly. The actual physical core for handling the task, GW, is installed in Arsenal. It's the only system in the world with an optic neural AI that has a parallel processing capacity of 980 trillion Hamets.
I suppose that being a specialist in neural AI and complex logic played a significant role in your association with the Metal Gear Project.
That's not the only reason.
What do you mean? I guess there are plenty of other reasons.
Yes, there are.
I understand.
Do you?
So Arsenal Gear was actually designed to protect the GW system, wasn't it?
Yes. It's armed with everything, including nuclear weapons, and is fully equipped with cyber-terrorist countermeasures. Physically and logically, it's the ultimate fortress for housing GW.
But is the AI actually capable of controlling everything?
No. GW is only the system's core. It's only for deciding what data is stored or deleted. The actual subsystem for executing the task exists within our social structure.
What?
Do you remember the panic that gripped the computer industry prior to the end of the century?
You mean the Y2K problem?
That's right. If you recall, our government supplied the world with a countermeasure program using the internet at full capacity. The program was distributed to every governmental organization, every key facility throughout the world. In addition, the same program was included in an OS application for distribution among the public.
Let me guess. The Y2K countermeasure contained a program designed by the Patriots.
Yes, and everything supplied from that day onward contains the same program.
Impossible!
Do you know how a computer operates? Do you really know the basic principles on how data is exchanged? Nobody's aware of it, but there's a subsystem in place, and it's about to be activated.
Is that why Solidus wants to burn out every electrical circuit in Manhattan with a nuclear blast?
Probably. But the overall system isn't actually complete.
What?
It still lacks the necessary factors for judging situations. I heard they were planning a major experiment in the next few days to provide complex data for GW to study. And suddenly all this happens.
Emma, it's not your fault. If it wasn't for the terrorists...
Yeah, you're right. Well, I think that's about all I know.
Right. Thanks. I think we'd better head for the computer room.
My bird in the computer room! Is he safe?
That noisy overgrown parakeet?
Excuse me, he's a parrot. And he's my best friend. My only friend.
Well, the bird's okay.
Good. Did you know that in the old days, miners used to take a canary into the mine shafts to detect toxic gas?
That's what he's for?
No. I really needed someone to talk to.
Right. I think we'd better get moving. We've got a little longer to cover than the last time.
I'll give it my best.
Whatever you do, don't open your eyes.
Why not?
A dead body, not a pretty sight.
Oh.
Once we get past it, it'll be too dark to see anything. What are those sticks in your head?
These? They're lacquered chopsticks. They hold your hair in place. Did you know that they're pretty popular in Europe and South America?
Can't say that I do. You're not only cute, but smart too.
Oh, I'm much more than cute.
Okay, let's go.
Why is Raiden such a piece of shit? Hey buddy, she just told you she invented a essentially world domination AI software. And he's like, wow, you're cute. Did you know that?